Chris, I wanted to talk about this article that Dino Flamia posted on New Jersey 101.5, our website, nj1015.com, about five topics couples should be talking about, but they are not. Love, money, communication, sex, and parenting. Now, it reads in an awkward way. I think sometimes therapists just say these things because it makes sense. So I thought, well, let me get a therapist to tell me if this is what it's stacked up to be or if it's a little bit ridiculous. So I'm joined by therapist Liz Mandel. Liz, welcome back to New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I am doing great. How are you?
I'm fantastic.
All right. So what do you think of this? I sent you this link so you take a look at it. I found it awkward that couples would really start a sentence by saying, one of the great things I appreciate about you is how you handle money. Is that bizarre? Am I wrong?
No, I mean, you know, a lot of these, articles on relationships, yes, they seem a little too sugar-coated and unrealistic, but really, it's meant to be like a script where people can kind of alter it to fit how they usually speak. So instead of saying, you know, what I love most about this relationship is, they can say something like, I love when we have sex. I love that our communication is great. And what would be even better, or what would make our sex life more fulfilling, or what would make our financial situation even stronger is this.
Right. You know, let me ask you, Liz, what do you think is the most important one of these five? Is it sex? Is it sex? Tell me why.
Because I'll tell you why. The reason why couples come to couples therapy, the number one reason is because they have unfulfilling sex lives. That is the number one reason. And so therefore, you can deduce that if that is not working, then they're going to end up in the therapist's office.
And typically, what's the problem? Is it that they're not communicating what each partner wants? What is it? What's the typical problem?
The typical problem is that the man is not getting enough sex from the woman.
Really? There is the secret to the problem in America with the high divorce rate. Is that it?
Pretty much. And also, I mean, the opposite is also true, that women are also not getting enough sex from their husbands if their husbands are suffering from ED and they don't want to talk about it. So if the wife is unfulfilled or if the husband is unfulfilled sexually, that's the reason why they will come to couples therapy, either before an infidelity occurs or after.
Wow. All right, let me ask you, what kind of advice, if you could share one tip, do you give people when they come to you with these problems? It seems bigger than just talking about it.
Okay. The thing that I emphasize to couples most is to be affectionate towards each other, and that's physically and verbally. The power of affection is so great that without it, couples can really feel very disconnected from each other. It can make it that much easier for them to get into a cycle or a routine where they are avoiding conflict. So using physical affection in a way that, you know, integrates their love into their daily routine is optimal. Holding hands, making eye contact, and the verbal affection, saying, I love you, you know, I can't wait to see you tonight, I'm looking forward to this weekend. That is a way for couples to not only reignite their passion, but keep it strong on a day-to-day basis. And, you know, going with the times, they can, you know, use verbal affection through text messaging, like a little text during the day. You know, I love you, thinking about you. So it's all part of the way that couples communicate, you know, verbally and non-verbally, that keeps their relationship strong.
I love it, Liz. Simple.